So good afternoon, everybody. My name is Kunal and my partner is
Yash Pagdar,
and we'll be presenting a presentation on Mercedes, the success story. So the tagline of Mercedes is best or nothing, and in some time you will get to know why. So the objective of our presentation is to show a story of a company which has put a lot of effort in establishing a car market and a segment in India.
Coming to introduction part, the Mercedes-Benz was founded on 28 June 1926 by Karl Benz and Gottlieb Daimler. Karl Benz was a German engineer and also automobile engineer. German engine designer or automobile engineer. The Gottlieb Daimler is an engineer and an industrialist. The Mercedes-Benz came into India by the truck market in India and collaborating with the telco in the duration of 1954 to 1969. Later on, the Mercedes-Benz entered the luxury car market in India with the model of E220 with the starting MRP price of 20 lakhs. The parent company of Mercedes-Benz is Daimler AG. Mercedes-Benz started its manufacturing plant in Pune itself in Chakan, and the other unit sold of Mercedes-Benz till now April 2019 is 1,14,867.
Alright, so let's to understand the success story of Mercedes, we will have to go through the company's timeline first. So it all began in year 1994 when Mercedes had entered with telco as a partner in India to begin the luxury car segment. The model which they came with was E-Class 220. In 1995, they released a diesel variant of the same model, but the road was a bit bumpy for them for the initial period. Up till 1998, the company had not seen much growth, but then after 1998, they released their C-Class as well as the mighty S-Class. And that's when the company gained its momentum, and that's when they understood that the Indian market requires more model, versatile models and newer versions of the models that they were producing in the country. By 1996, the production size capacity of Mercedes in India was 10,000 units every year, and by the year 2014, they had produced their 58,000 car in the market, and just in 4 years ahead of it, in 2018, the number went up to 1 lakh.
So coming to the sales revenue of the Mercedes-Benz, in 2019, the revenue of Mercedes-Benz was 6,183 crores INR, while the profit in that year was 376 crores. In 2018, the revenue of the Mercedes-Benz was 6,078 crores, and the profit itself is 305 crores.
Now you can see there's a fall in the profit as well as the revenue of the company, and that is because of many factors such as the ban which was put on for cars which had a MRP of more than 10 lakhs, as well as GST and demonetization. Mind you, Mercedes has always been pleading to the government to reduce the GST of imported and luxury cars to a bracket of 18% rather than the 28% which it currently resides in.
Now coming to sales figure, units sold per year in 2014 to 2015 was 13,502. In 2015 to 16, the units sold was 13,231. By little bit hike in 2016 and 17, no, it was a higher hike, 15,030 unit was sold. In 2017 to 18, 15,538 units sold. In 2018-19, there was a decline of some amount, and the unit sold was 14,860. As my friend told, the decline was just because of the taxation and the demonetization also. The other challenge, the other was the the old availability of the old luxury cars was higher in the market, so that's why the sales was decreased in 2018 and 2019.
All right, so let's talk about the market share. The market share over here, we can see there are two pie charts. One is in 2018 and another one is for 2017. The 2018 total market share for luxury car segment was 40,340. That is the total size of the market, among which Mercedes stands for 15,538 units annually. And for 2017, if we see, the market share was 39,989. That is the total size of the market, and Mercedes stands at 50,330 units.
So now the reason for success of Mercedes-Benz in India. The first reason is the head start. Mercedes-Benz came into the India 10 years before the competitors was came to India. So the Mercedes-Benz got that get literally a decade to deepen their roots and strengthen their roots. They also started the research and development organization in the Bengaluru. And the other reason is the vast product range. Mercedes-Benz have a diversified car ranges. Their cars started from the 20 lakhs to 7.5 crores. So each and every people who want to buy that car get an option according to their affordability. The third reason is the production capacity. When Mercedes-Benz was came to India, the production capacity was around 10,000 units per year. Later on, in 2014, they started another manufacturing plants in Chakan, and the production capacity increased to 20,000. By the increasing the production capacity, the Mercedes-Benz was able to meet the customer needs and to produce the various models of Mercedes.
Now let's talk about the rest of the 3 points, because this is half part of the story. So what happened exactly? Why do we want to buy Mercedes rather than Maruti if given a chance? Well, the obvious answer would be material quality, build quality of the automobile, and also the tag that it is an export makes it a big difference. And that's how Mercedes played it in India. And they had, since as he said, they had a head start of 10 years. So they got to analyze the market, they got to make the strategies and understand the Indian market, and that's how they went ahead. So let's talk about the competitors that Mercedes have in India. We'll start with BMW. The sales figure of BMW are given, as you can see, for 2018 it is around 11,105 units, and for 2017 it was around 9,800 units. So you can see there's an increase of 13.32%. And as we follow down, we can see the sales figure for Volvo, for Audi, and as well as JLR, which stands for Jaguar and Land Rover. So let's talk about the conclusion. So in this presentation, we have talked about our objective, our introduction, the timeline, and every other aspect which makes Mercedes a success story. Because ultimately, a car brand which got to analyze the market, which has been leading in the global market and now in the Indian market as well for last 4 or 5 years, it has retained its top position. So that does speak in volumes about the automobile company, and that's where we would like to conclude. Thank you.
Thank you.